company that we chose is Dutch Ready Milk Industries Berhad. Okay, this company is a manufacturer of cow milk and dairy products in Malaysia since 1960. And it was located in Petaling Jaya, Selangor. The production of this company is powder milk, condensed milk, cultured milk, yogurt and fruit juice drinks. And the second company that we chose is Nestle Malaysia Berhad. Nestle Malaysia Berhad is a Malaysian-based nutrition, health and wellness company. This company segments include food, beverage and others. It was originated in Malaysia since 1912 in Penang and moved to Kuala Lumpur in 1939. And now, their head office is located in Mutiara Damansara. The production of this company is chocolates, dairy products, coffee, creamer, bottled water, ice cream, baby food, seasoning and also pet food. And the popular products for this company is Milo, Nescafe, KitKat, Nestum, Coco Crunch, Honey Star, Power Bar and many more. Okay, now I will proceed to the last part for my presentation, which is executive summary. This report outlines is the financial statement analysis of two firms for the last 2 years, 2018 to 2020. The goal is to show the company's performance, particularly in terms of financial results. This report using 5 main categories in financial ratios. And the last one is the findings are presented in graphical format, allowing us to observe the pattern for each ratios analysis as well as the company performance from 2018 to 2020. And now we are continuing to the next presenter, Danisha.
How liquid is your organization? Current ratio for both company has decreased from 2019 to 2020, but still, Dutch Lady has the highest current ratio. Dutch Lady is more liquid and also stable than Nestle. Higher ratios, higher ability to pay current and maturing liabilities on time. Are the managers generating an adequate operating profit on the organization's asset? Operating profit margin for both company has decreased from 2019 to 2020. But still, Dutch Lady has the higher profit margin. Dutch Lady has more efficiency to control the cost and expenses. Dutch Lady is earning well from the business to pay the cost and also the expenses. How is your organization financing its asset? Debt ratio for both company has increased from 2019 to 2020. But Dutch Lady has the low debt ratio than Nestle. Higher debt ratio indicates that the risk is high. Dutch Lady has the potential of longevity as it has low debt ratio. It is important for Nestle to analyze the long-term financial risk for their company. Interest time earned for both company has increased from 2019 to 2020. But Dutch Lady has the highest interest time earned than Nestle. Higher ratio is desirable as it indicates higher margin of safety. Dutch Lady indicates that firm can make loan charges and lower default risk. Nestle has high risk to investors and creditors in terms of solvency. Are the managers generating a good return on equity? Return on equity for Dutch Lady has decreased from 82.59% to 47.67%, while Nestle has increased from 19.79% to 23.74%. Dutch Lady has high return on equity in both 2019 and 2020. Return on equity helps to know about the percentage return earned by the equity shareholders.
Okay, now I would like to explain the success factors and risk factor of both Dutch Lady Milk Industries and Nestle Company. The first risk factor that Dutch Lady Milk Industries faced was process disruption. To overcome that, they had some contingency plans which they reviewed regularly to solve that risk. Other than that, product quality and food safety risk. So they add some RFC internal quality and food safety system with focused quality program and undergo periodic audit verification. The next risk factor is unfavorable development of the company's financial position. So they overcome with some procedures for planning, budgeting, forecasting, and assessing business operations. The last risk factors was effectiveness, adequacy, and the integrity of the system. So there were no material losses incurred during the current financial year as a result of weaknesses in internal control. The first risk factor that Nestle Berhad faces was business disruption resulting from a pandemic or global crisis. So in order to that, they collaborate and keep in close contact with their business partner to ensure safety and ensure minimal disruption in business supply. The next risk factor was major fluctuation in prices of commodities and materials. So for that, they ensure minimal interruption of the supply. They also source from multiple suppliers which are approved based on global and local standards. The last risk factor was cybersecurity attacks and fraud and corruption. So the security controls have been implemented to identify security risk based on National Cyber Risk Framework. They have created awareness through various complaints, training program and risk assessments on anti-corruption and complaints related issues.
Projection. Organization's financial health and performance of Dutch Lady and Nestle Malaysia. Every company's financial health is based on their identification of how might be improved their financial ratios. Financial ratios are used to be make comparison between different aspects of a company performance or how the company stack ups within a particular industry or region. Through a financial performance analysis, specific financial formulas and ratios are calculated, which when compared to historical and industry metrics, provide insight to a company's financial condition and performance.
Highlights of projection. First, liquidity. Since each of the ratio is below 1, Nestle and Dutch Lady has high risk in bankruptcy activity. Nestle has a poor performance in 2020 compared to 2019 than Dutch Lady. Both company decrease in the number of times in turn its total asset into sales, and the return on total assets companies decrease in the year 2020. Third, leverage. Nestle and Dutch Lady show a total increase of 29% and 2% in its debt ratio in the year 2020 as compared to the previous year. Time interest earn ratio of both companies are greater than 2.5, which is considered an acceptable risk. Fourth, profitability. Both companies' performance has shown a decrease of operating profit margin in the year 2020 as compared to the year 2019 due to the recent COVID-19 pandemic and the introduction of various measures with market or share. Based on the price-earning ratio for the two consecutive years, both companies show that the ratios are steady. For dividend payout ratio, Nestle has shown a healthy payout ratio for 2 years compared to Nestle. Recommendation. First, managing current ratio. The current ratio has significant influence towards Dutch Lady and Nestle performance. When there is too much current asset proportion, there will be negative impact on return on equity of company. Second, eliminating unproductive asset can be used by Dutch Lady and Nestle. Financial ratios above, the company's efficiency in managing its assets to generate profits are decreasing. Third, assessing and eliminating unnecessary overhead costs. Lowering overhead has a direct impact on profitability, as it may help to increase the number of profit generated by both companies. Not only that, reducing its overhead costs may also help to improve the company's net profit margin. Fourth, effective policy and agreement credit. This is especially important as Nestle has taken a longer time to collect the amount due from its account receivable in the year 2020.
Conclusion. We can determine the company's financial condition and result of their operating performance of their managerial and other problem areas. As for both companies, Dutch Lady and Nestle, the company of Dutch Lady shows better result in the financial ratios calculation compared to Nestle Berhad for within 2 years, 2020 to 2020. Lastly, it is complicated to decide which company come out with a good performance as required in the Bursa Malaysia and the Companies Act 1965, since the measures and rules are used as part of the company's financial policy.